Father Lord, we just want to bless you this morning for another privilege you have given unto us to know this day. We travel a while, boat, air, with a car, with our feet, but you kept us. May your name alone be glorified this morning. We submit the service unto you, Father. What you will not say, what you will not do, will happen in this service. So that we declare the lordship over the service, Lord, that every territory is dominated by you, even our heart, our soul, our spirit, and our bodies submitted to you. Rule, reign in our heart, O Lord. Let us be the doer, not the hearer alone, for we want to be blessed. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father, for the land of South Africa, that you continue to prosper the land. Thank you for every soul is blessed. Thank you for you wipe off every coronavirus, that all disease have been destroyed completely. That shame unto the devil himself. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for none of your children shall be afflicted with those viruses. That, oh Lord, even when we step our feet or drink the serpent or poison, that nothing shall harm us. Father, we triumph on this morning because of your presence in our life. Glory be to your name, hallelujah. Our brothers and sisters all over the world in the hospital, we soak them in the blood of Jesus Christ. We call an end to all sickness and disease in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Good morning once again. Hallelujah. Choir, forgive me this morning. I follow the lead of the Holy Spirit. He just says to me, proceed. I actually want to join you and dance with you, but he said, I'll proceed. Hallelujah. And we'll be talking about grace this morning. Hallelujah. I prefer grace than love. Will you prefer law or grace? I prefer as Pastor King. I prefer grace than law. So I would say to you this morning, what the law couldn't do, grace has done it all. Amen. Hallelujah. I mean, what the law could not do because it was failing, grace did it all. Hallelujah. Good morning. Those who are here on Thursday, hallelujah, they will be receiving the double dose of this message. And I thank God for the grace given to me to preach the same message again, but it might text it in a different way this morning. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bible to the book of Philemon. The only chapter of the Bible, one chapter. Hallelujah, the book of Philemon. You will find that book after Genesis as you move forward without reaching Revelation. Somewhere there is Eden. And if you look at your Bible, that page is very fresh. It's never been touched because the letter was so simple and so small. We like to read the letter of Paul that is so big or so, but this one has never been touched. Hallelujah. Are you there?
Amen.
This letter of Philemon is the shortest letter of Apostle Paul. Thank you for reminding them. After 2 Timothy, Titus, and whatever, you find it. Say to your neighbor, I'm not lost. I'm not lost. I found it. Yeah, if you have lost, ask the next neighbor to help you locate it quickly. We don't want to leave you behind. Hallelujah. This is one of the shortest letters of Apostle Paul, written to Philemon, where the church of Colossians meets. There is a church where they always meet, in the house of Philemon. Those days, there was not a church like this apart from the synagogue. So most of the church started from home, like a house fellowship. Hallelujah. I will be shortening the story of Philemon this morning. Philemon is a slave owner. And if you look at the Old Testament, in the Roman history, the more of you having a slave, the more power you have. The number of the slaves you have determine how rich you are. Hallelujah. So people have slaves. I'm talking about human beings. They have slaves who works in their farms, who works in their house. And I want to tell you, slave is different from a servant or a messenger. Slave is bought. Messenger is never bought. It's perhaps a job that you can quit at any time. But slave, you become a property of the owner who place monetary value on you. Am I communicating? So that is who slave is. So slave is actually closer to the family than the servant. Hallelujah. Because your servant may not be will to your children when you are gone. But the slave becomes the owner and becomes the property of the owner. When the will is being read, the slave is part of the property that will be shared among the children. Am I communicating? Slave will be shared among the children because it becomes the rightful owner. Then, those days, there's a legal document that is written that this one I bought in. And if a slave gave birth to children, the owner owns the children of the slave. Because it's like you're feeding the goats that you own. So whatever the slave have, is owner property. Hallelujah. I want you to have that so that before we proceed. Yeah. Hallelujah. Let's start our reading. I have two key verses there, which is 6, 16 and 18. But I want us to start reading from verse 1. And as we are reading, please very slow, please take notes. Find your position here. You must find your position in this scripture. Who are you? Hallelujah. Who is reading for us this morning?
Amen.
Good morning. Yes, you can read very slow.
Paul, a prisoner of Christ Jesus, and Timothy, our brother, to Philemon, our dear friend and fellow worker, to Apphia, our sister, to Archippus, our fellow soldier, and to the church that meets in your own. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I always thank my God as I remember you in my prayers, because I hear about your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all the saints. I pray that you may be active in sharing your faith, so that you will have a full understanding of every good thing we have in Christ. Your love has given me great joy and encouragement, because you, brother, have refreshed the hearts of the saints. Verse 8. Therefore, although in Christ I could be bold and order you to do what you ought to do, yet I appeal to you on the basis of love. I then, as Paul, an old man, and now also a prisoner of Christ Jesus, appeal to you for my son Onesimus, who became my son while I was in chains. Formerly, he was useless to you, but now he has become useful both to you and me. Verse 12. I am sending him, who is my very heart, back to you. I would have liked to keep him with me, so that he could take your place in helping me while I am in chains for the gospel. But I did not want to do anything without your consent, so that any favor you do will be spontaneous and not forced. Verse 15. Perhaps the reason he was separated from you for a little was that you might have him back for good, no longer as a slave, but better than a slave. As a dear brother, he is very dear to me, but even dearer to you, both as a man and as a brother in the Lord. Verse 17. So if you consider me a partner, welcome him as you would welcome me. If he has done to you any wrong or owes you anything, charge it to me. Verse 19, I, Paul, am writing this with my own hand. I will pay it back, not to mention that you owe me your very self. I do wish, brother, that I may have some benefit from you in the Lord. Refresh my heart in Christ. Confident of your obedience, I write to you, knowing that you will do even more than I ask.
Let's stop there. Hallelujah. Good morning once again. If you look at that scripture, Paul is actually strengthening up his faith towards other believers that he actually has the track record of his behavior. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Will you permit me to be a teacher this morning?
Yes. But when it comes to
Bible, the Bible is the Holy Spirit itself. For the one to read is for one to understand. And for you to understand, you must have the Holy Spirit in you. Hallelujah. So if you don't have the Holy Spirit, you will read the Bible, but you understand the scripture based on human knowledge. But if you have the Holy Spirit in you when you read the Bible, you understand the Bible based on the spiritual knowledge. In this context we have just read, the book of Philemon, Apostle Paul is actually representing Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The position in which Apostle Paul stood is Jesus. Where he was standing is standing in Christ. And the slave is actually referring to the Christian. I mean, where Apostle Paul is standing in the place of God. The slave is referring to we Christian. And Philemon is referring to who? Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. In this context, he said, this man who have run away from you, meaning he was his possession before, there was service that he had been rendering in that house. And now, Onesimus has done something wrong. He could be stealing from his master. It could be anything, but he has committed a sin that makes him to run away. It's no longer in the book record, in the good record of his master anymore. Are you hearing me? It's not worthy to come to the presence of Philemon. Hallelujah. He has committed what? A sin. And that makes him to run. It is running. He met who? He met who? God. In the person of Apostle Paul. And without meeting God, he cannot meet with Christ. I don't think you are getting this analogy. Without you, if you have not met with God, you cannot meet with Christ. He said, for those who the Father has given me, they are mine. And it's no one who will come to me without my Father drawing them. Do you still remember that scripture? Now, in his running, he became a fugitive. He was running away from his master. And he met someone. And the person has a relationship with his boss. Did you get me? The person he met had a relationship with his boss. And the person said, no, we are partners. And it's no more a slave. It's who? It's a brother. Don't take him. No, I have the right to tell you to take him by force. But I want you to consider within your heart
take in, but not as slave anymore. As who? As a brother. I say to you, I prefer grace than love, than law. Grace is no punishment, but law is not about punishment. Hello? Law is about what? Punishment. Grace is not. Grace is full of forgiveness. Hallelujah. What do we need to forgive? Anything. Is it small or big? As big, as small as it is, you need to forgive. Grace will remove, it removes punishment. And not only remove punishment, it places you on a higher position. That sin that you have committed cannot qualify you to be. Hello? You have sinned. There is a punishment that is awaiting you based on what you have done. Now you are not worthy to be called a son. Are you following me? You are not worthy to be called a son. I mean, you are not worthy to be called a servant in this scenario. Then he ran. Now he met with God. Instead of being demoted, he was lifted up. More than what he qualified for. Are you not? How many of us as a Christian here who somebody has offended and you promote them, even when you are forgiving them? How many of you as a Christian here who have a friend before and something got wrong and you see him as a friend better than before? Hello? You are the person. Are you? Eh? Have you had a friend like that? He got into your good book again. Eh? Hallelujah. No, we keep that in our black record even though we are forgiving them. We will take our relationship and we'll give them a distance relationship. We turn them as enemy even though we forgive them. Look at the verses of that book. Who can read? Can you read verses of that book of him for us?
I pray that you may be active,
yes,
in sharing your faith.
Who is he praying to? Apostle Paul says, I pray that you may be what? Active in what?
Sharing your faith.
Every Christian must be active in sharing their faith. What is faith? Eh? Faith is trusting God to do what you could not do. Faith is allowing God to act on your behalf. Hallelujah. We oftentimes say to forgive is divine. To what? What is the second part?
Hell
is human. No human being can please God. Because all about hell is human. I'm not the one who wrote that. All about hell is human. And eyes for eyes. That's what the law taught us. Even parents teaches their children today. I've seen many women here. If you give your sign or your eyes to your child, is to beat another child. Hello? Mothers in the house? Eh? Your child cried to you that somebody just beat him or her. In the midst of the crowd, you may not say a word. But you can give a signal to your child to go and beat that child back. Hello? Without saying anything. Mama, were you not there? You cry. Everyone. It's just because you are the only saint here. Who laughed? Hallelujah. You can give a sign and your child went go back. But I didn't ask you to beat back. You're a liar. Hallelujah. In that book, Apostle Paul says, you have to share your faith. You need to expand that faith you have in Christ Jesus to another. To expand your faith is to actually do what a human being cannot do. We are overprotective of ourselves these days. Thinking that the one who was once friend is now enemy. When Christ died for us on the cross of Calvary, It does not discriminate. Even those who crucified him, they knew not what they were doing. Hallelujah. Among those soldiers, are you hearing me now? Among those Pharisees, the one who received Christ as his Lord and Savior rests in the bosom of God, even though they are the one who killed Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. If Judas repents genuinely, it will be in heaven. Hallelujah. Let's read verse 8 of that same scripture.
Therefore, although in Christ, yet I appeal to you on the basis of love.
Hallelujah. Is it although in Christ, meaning the relationship they share together in Christ, it can just say, receive it. But it reminded him that I'm doing it based on the relationship we have in Christ Jesus. The relationship we have in Christ Jesus kept us together. But we are failing to exercise that relationship from the deep of our heart to one another. When somebody does something wrong today to you, you never clear the record from your head. It remains a stigma, and it costs you to relate with that person in a different way. Hallelujah. Apostle Paul says, no, he's a slave when he did that. But now, he has met with God, receiving back, accepting back as a son, as a brother. Hallelujah. As a brother. Meaning, it is not about the sin he committed, but he said, take this upon me. Everything he has done to you, I take the blame. That is exactly what Jesus Christ did on the cross. He took our blame. Hallelujah. Can you come, brother? Can you come? Yes, brother Peter. Can you come, brother? Come. Hallelujah. I said to you, you permit me to be in the class this morning. Hallelujah. Can you come, brother? Come. Brother G, brother God, eh? Brother God, let's call him God. Are you capable of being in the position of God? Eh? Are you capable? Are you capable? It's true. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Here's the one who stole from his master. You have never stolen before. Just an example. Hallelujah. He stole from this man. This is the book of Philemon I'm trying to put into practical for you. He stole from this man. And I'm here, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. But here's God. When this brother stole from this man, the owner, he ran. He is his property. This is Philemon. Are you Philemon by name? Yes, Philemon. A servant, his name, I mean, I stole from him. He's not worthy of being in his presence anymore. He ran. In his running, he met with God. And when you meet with God, you are met with Jesus. Every sin I confessed, he became a Christian. God would have taken. But he said, no. I'm taking you back to where you come from. But I take you back. I'm sending you back to where you come from because I know that man. Hallelujah. That man is my partner. I know this man. I have the right to hold you here. But I want you to go back to that place so that you become an exemplary of what this man teaches. Philemon is a born-again Christian.
In his house, they were holding a cell meeting.
Let me call it a cell meeting because that's what we do now. It's a house fellowship. The Colossian people meet in his house to read the Bible, to study the Word of God. And one of his slaves has run. Do you think the members of the household wouldn't know? Hello? Do you know the rest of the Christian there doesn't know that that Onesimus has run? He has stolen from this brother? Hallelujah. And the message of grace is an acceptance of Christ Jesus that brings us back to our original position. And the Lord wants to demonstrate it in Philemon. And as this man yielded to God, he sent him back. Are you hearing him? He yielded to this God and he sent him back. This man is no more treating him as a slave. Perhaps before, a slave used a different plate to eat when the master is using gold. Maybe he will use, what is it called? Not Tupperware. A leaf. Hallelujah. Because there's always a difference between slave and the master. Even the children of the master is also a master to the slave. But when this brother shall return, he was taken as the member of the family. Instead of punishing him, he took him now. More dear to his heart. So is the story of the prodigal son. Are you hearing me? Same is the story of prodigal son. Hallelujah. It's not about self-righteous. It is not what this man has done. It is what Jesus did. Are you hearing me? Not this man, because it's a runaway man who has stolen from his master. But he repents when he meets with Jesus. And when you repent, Jesus restores. Hallelujah. Luke 16.
No longer as a slave. But better than a slave.
No longer as a slave, but what? Better than a slave.
As a dear brother.
As a dear brother.
Yes. He is very dear to me.
He's very dear to me.
But even dearer to you.
Oh, Jesus. The one who met him, who he met, the poor, who is God, he said, this man is very near to me, but he's more to you, because I want you to be a custodian of that grace. Is there any one of us here who practices that? Hallelujah. Eh? Is there anyone who have lost your good record and been restored to that good record? Hallelujah. This is exactly what Jesus wants us to preach to one another. Hallelujah. This is the meaning of let love lead. This is total forgiveness. This man must not remind him, although you stole my spoon, my golden spoon. No, you are not qualified until I see Paul. No, go back to your old room at the back of the house. No, still use the leaf to hit food. No, he restored him to original position. Most of the people we call enemy today, they are friends of God. Those who have persecuted you in the past, they are actually friends of God. Those who mock you, they are friends of God. Say to your neighbor, don't quick to judge. Say to another neighbor, grace is better than the law. What the law couldn't do, grace has done it all. Are you saying to that neighbor? You are tired. I said, what the law couldn't do, in that it was powerless, grace has done it all. That's it. Grace restored Onesimus. And Onesimus find favor because of the one he met. And the one he met was actually in his master, Philemon. And he brought them together. He said, no, I would have owned him. Because he's dear to me. But I want him to go to you so that you can actually preach what you are preaching, you can practice it. What you have been listening to here in this mountain, in this altar, have you been practicing it? When your test of faith comes, what do you do? When it is time to practice this message, do you? It is always minus Jesus plus me. Let's do it. Hallelujah. Jesus is looking for someone who can stand as he stood for us all. Can you stand for the nice person beside you? Hallelujah. Ask your neighbor, can you stand for me? If things are going worse than this, can you stand for me? Ask that neighbor. You wouldn't. Say to that neighbor, you wouldn't. Because you're just a mere human. God wants us to be spiritual. And so it is when we read the word of God, you need to read it by the Holy Spirit. And you can only read the word of God by the Holy Spirit if you are not grieving the Spirit. You cannot be hate of another. Hatred, you can show hatred to another and read the scripture and understand. You cannot be bitter and read the scripture and understand. If you have every opposite of what Holy Spirit is, you will read the scripture, but you only have the knowledge of man. Because when the time the scripture needs to be a being, you will not allow it. Say to your neighbor, how many times have you hindered the scripture? Say to that neighbor again, don't be an entrance to the scripture. The word of God is life. Human being is an entrance to that word. I believe I'm speaking to a spiritual being this morning. Eh? I'm speaking to a spiritual being who is ready to confess their sin and ask for forgiveness. Who is ready to practice what the scripture says? Who does not compromise the word of God? Hallelujah. Word of God is profitable. It nourishes our flesh. But the more we thought we have better what the Bible says, we are in a journey of destruction. You will take your divine helper as your enemy, and you will lose the purpose of which that man or her has been ordained as a divine helper to you. Hallelujah. How do you think that the ministry of this man will be? Philemon, who can tell us what will become of this man? Hello, you remember we're in the class? What will become the ministry of this man? Yeah? Much more blessed. Even the congregation will be full. Because whatever he says, it does. Hallelujah. Many build houses today, they destroy it by their character. Many pastors as a big church, they destroy it by their character. Hallelujah. Many wives has children, but they have scattered their children by their character. So is the husband. When it is time for you to practice the word of God, that is the time of your promotion. When you are to be genuinely answered to the call, that is the time of your promotion. Your promotion wouldn't come when you are praying, because no interruption in prayer. But when you are walking out of that prayer and you begin to meet people, meeting people is the time of your promotion. Hallelujah. When those who are closer to you before, they are not more close. When they begin to call your name, hallelujah. You call me stupid, you are more three times stupid than me. Because they call you stupid, does that mean you are stupid? Can't you pretend stupid in order to win the one who is stupid? Amen. Hello? Hallelujah. Because I call him stupid. And he knows that he's not stupid. And I began to say, you are stupid. Who is not stupid now? It's me. But he kept quiet that he's not stupid.
But if he said, I'm stupid, it's two stupid people who are shouting on one another. But he maintained that I'm not stupid. Even though the eyes witness changes his mind. This guy should be stupid because that man has been saying he's stupid. He began to look at your eyes. Do you believe you can make him to lose Christ? If indeed he doesn't have the Christ before? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Did you get what I'm saying? I give him a punch. He wasn't ready to reply, but when he looked at you, your face, your countenance shows that
banana.
And he's not ready. But because the way he looks at you, he looks stupid in your eyes. And he wants to prove to you that he's not stupid. And he went back in order to give me so that you can question. He will be losing Christ. Many of us today, somebody break your spoon. Just your spoon. Come on, spoon and go. You put his house in fire. Or fire. It's just a spoon. Just a spoon. Now you put fire in his house. What is spoon compared with the house burning? These are the way of revenge. Those who revenge. You are worst enemy to God if you take a revenge on your brother. Hello? Because the one who offended you may not even know what he was doing. But you who retaliate offense, you know what you are doing. Hello? Oh, I mistakenly retaliate. Mistakenly? No, there's no mistake in retaliate. Is there any mistake in retaliate? Many are walking devil in the midst of Christians and the parabolic churches. Their character will not change. No matter how the message is preached to them, they will not change. God is looking for someone who everything he has been stolen. And if the person come with a repentant heart, he takes him. Even when the Lord says, crucify him. That's what the cross was saying there. The man in the right hand of God, of Jesus Christ, has been judged to death. Hello? I mean, the armed robber has been judged to death. But when he meets Christ Jesus, he will acknowledge who he is. And where the stubborn man who is also one being judged, if it's Christ, why can he help himself out? But the spirit of repentance came into this one and said, no, this is the Son of God. And that makes him make heaven. You can be in the church throughout your 100 years on this planet. That does not mean you are a candidate of heaven. Hello? Being good does not mean you are a candidate of heaven. It's being who Christ wants you to be. How many of us who still want to be what Christ wants us to be?
How many of us here?
No, we want to be what we want to be. We want to be known. We want people to notice us. We want our presence to be felt in the society. Everybody must know I come to church today. Yes, I'm in choir. Whatever I say goes. No, I'm an usher. Everybody must know I'm here. Where is Christ? Hallelujah. You could drive all your members of every members of your house to church. But can you take them to heaven? Hello? Jesus is not looking for a pretend Christian. Say to your neighbor, don't pretend. Salvation is not pretending. It's genuine from the heart. Hallelujah. Verses, can you read that verses again? He said, the faith, let her read.
I pray that you may be active in sharing your faith. So that you will have a full understanding of every good thing we have in Christ.
Being active in faith will only allow you to have a part in what we profess and what we have in Christ Jesus. What do we have in Christ Jesus? Hallelujah. Let's open to another scripture. John and Philip. There's a scripture I want us to look at. Let's look at the book of John 15. God bless you, Onesimus. I mean, Philemon. God bless you, Onesimus. Hallelujah. Mr. God, you can see that. Hallelujah. You may be like Onesimus. You may be Philemon. All what God is achieving is the grace must be preached among us. Grace must be preached. Book of John 15:15. 15, 15.